God. Right? The producer of Kids Who Need Mobile coming up. At the back behind us, the good audience. Holy shit.
Was it light? How did you do
it? Huh?
Was it light?
Light hearted. Sign of life.
My heart just goes up.
It leaves your body, so your body becomes lighter.
It's like a
bubble
family, right?
It's all about family, guys. It's all about loving your family. Please sit. Jesus. I know I've lost 600 calories watching your food. Great workout for me.
You're a believer?
Huh?
You're a believer?
I'm a believer. I've been a believer since it's premiered. Raw 600 calories, my sinuses are open, so it's great time. I watched this film when it premiered in September of last year, and it's been 9 months since, and I had completely forgotten how hot Lush is. I was sitting next to Rajshree over there, and at one point she just went, Now, Nikhil, you've said about this, the origin of the story, over and over, and we've heard you say this, that you were on a train and you saw a robbery happening. So, but I will ask you to repeat that story one more time for this brand new audience that's just experienced KILL for the first time. When did the idea for KILL first come to you?
Thank you guys for watching the film. So last September I'd come over here and I'd watched the film at Beyond Fence, and they were chanting, "Kill, kill, kill, kill." Oh my God. So, yeah, sorry, coming back to your question.
Yes, it came to you when you were actually on a train during a journey. This is a brand new audience, so please repeat one more time.
So, it's way back in 94, 95, when I was a student, and I used to say, so my hometown was in Patna, which was eastern side.
Patna fans.
And I used to study in Pune, which was almost around. Yes, so. A lot of fans from both the cities. Great. So I used to travel 3 to 4 times in a year. And in one of those journeys, when I boarded the train around 11:30, I just went off to sleep. It was a sleeper class. Sleeper class is something which is where you do not have air condition coached. It's so you have to just lift the window and make the wind come in. Right?
Yeah.
That was it. Yeah. No focus. A lot of stench, of course. So and I slept off, and the next morning at around 7 or 8 o'clock, we used to reach Prayagraj at that time in Allahabad. And it was winter, so I was very fond of goggles, and Prayagraj has very good goggles. So I got up in the morning to have goggles.
Okay.
And the train did not reach Allahabad. And I docked at some small desolate village, and when I got out, I saw a lot of goggles. And that's when I got to know that the next coach, which was the first class coach, was getting robbed while I was sleeping. And so and that's when I got to know that they were robbing for almost 4 to 5 hours. They beat up passengers, they stabbed a couple of them, so it was a very horrific sight when I saw it. And just next to Patna is a place called Dhanapur, which is a camp area, and there were some soldiers were traveling in my coach.
Yeah.
And when they saw all this, they started saying that, you know, if the robbers would have attempted to rob our food, you would have shown them what
we're made of.
What we're made of.
Yeah.
So this story stayed with me for 25 years. I don't know why it did not strike me earlier, but, you know, every story has its own book. In 2016, I thought that I should write it down.
Yeah. And about 40 deaths?
How many?
There were supposed to be 52, like in the script.
Compromise.
Yeah. So.
Not sadistic at all.
Yeah, I reduced 10 deaths.
You know, if you spend any...
My heart is broken.
Nikhil is so weird. If you spend any time with him, he's like the most soft-spoken, gentle, like polite guy. Like he'll get up and give you his chair the minute you enter a room and just look at the film he's made. There is a Kim in his name.
Correct.
You can't spell Nikhil without Kim. Kim and Nikhil. Made to make Kim. Was born to make Kim. You are, you know, you Sikhya. Okay, this beautiful indie production house in Andheri West. Lovely people, dogs are in the office and cats are in the office. And it's a lovely, beautiful place. How did you come on board this damn thing, Guneet?
She's wearing red.
Guneet has been doing method dressing, by the way. Please go to her Instagram and look at all her stylistic choices. They're all red colored. How did Sikhya come on board this particular film?
Actually, we always wanted, I mean, we made an Elephant Whispers last year and...
Casual Oscar winner? Casual Oscar?
We actually got some plays and we always wanted to go extreme action, non-stop action film, but never really had an opportunity of finding a script.
Yeah.
And a filmmaker that we absolutely love. So, in a casual conversation between Nikhil and I was like, what are you doing next? Let's figure it out. Let's work together. Let's try and find something. He said, I have a film. Nobody will make it. And I was like, oh, what's that? He was like, no, forget it. I said, no, tell me. So then he said, well, it's an action film. It's not an action. It's a run like Lunchbox and Masan, Gangster Buster. But like dramas, you know, besides Gangster Buster. But like, you know, people do dramas, but yes. Technically, nobody would think that we would do an action film, let alone India's most violent film. But I think as producers, we love stories. And this, for me, was an emotional action film.
It is.
So, I think it was a brilliant story. It was a brilliant script. And more than that, if anybody, you know, like, anybody understood filmmaking, and of course, so many people there understand, Nikhil actually wrote out every piece of action. So it was a brilliant script. And he took time to go find everything he could use in a train to kill.
I traveled a lot.
Yeah. And he used to smoke back then, so he had a...
Yeah, so I had... Items. It was not allowed back then to carry zippo items.
On trains?
On trains.
Oh.
But I used to smuggle them.
Yeah.
How? Just chupa ke chupa. Fire extinguisher.
Okay, fire extinguisher is always there on the train. I didn't have to bring it.
The size of the knives increases your tension as the film goes on. Like, the bigger the knife, you know, the gorier the death is going to be. Did you have a weapons department to be like, abhi hasli niklegi, abhi katta niklega, abhi gun niklegi?
So, every knife had a name.
Like, every gunna has a name in this film, every knife also has a name.
Yes, every knife, had a name because thanks to Zubi, our prosthetic head of department, she said that she needed to know what's the size of the knife 3.5 or 4 months in advance because she wanted to make the molds. So she wanted to know who this knife is going to, whose cheek or whose eye. So she wanted to know the name of the person and name of the knife. So how does that knife travel from the Boon's hand into Lakshmi's hand? So that was a trajectory which we had to, like, you know, have to map.
Yeah.
And we had to map that some 4 months before we shot. So that, and that, it's all because of Zubi.
Yeah.
Yeah, she made us work so much.
Yes. I mean, you know, when you watch a film a second time, these are the details that you notice a little bit more, the sizes of the knives, the styles of the knives, the way people are holding those knives. But also, you notice the foley sound, right? Because the fire extinguisher smashing someone's head, that's probably a watermelon in a studio somewhere. How long did you spend doing the sound design on this?
Almost around 6 months. almost 6 months. And you know, there's special, say for example, Siddhi, the huge guy, the moment he used to punch, his punch used to strike, he had just increased it by 0.2 dB,
yeah,
and the rest of the punches. So that it should feel, yeah, it should feel that there's more power in his punches. And talking about Siddhi, part of the actors, he's one guy who's extremely involved in his performances. So much so that what you've seen, like how the number of times he's triangulating Laksh, he's actually doing that because he forgot that he's acting.
What else?
Yes. And there were so many times like when he was pressing his face against the wall, he was actually pressing his face, and he was like, Laksh was tapping him out. It's done.
My big step on my head.
So, yeah.
I love the moment where Siddhi makes peace with the fact that his father is dead, but then he touches his father's feet and then he gets up to start killing again. So the man of like morals.
Yeah, that's a respect.
Respect. Like, respect Puri Obisai. Will you talk to me about putting together the HODs, the cinematography department, and picking those people who are going to make this film with Nikhil? Rafe, for instance, the cinematographer. Just, I mean, the cinematography of this film, you guys. Yes!
So actually, as a production company, we were long back with Ravi Manohar, and we worked a lot with him previously. We did a film called Forget, and we had the most beautiful working experience with him. And he actually is like one of the best professors in film university in India for cinematography.
Right.
So he's not one of the, you know, like there are so many amazing cinematographers in India. But he actually taught many of them. He's much older, wiser, and the wise person on the set. So we used to actually call him Professor Sir.
She lied to me because she said that, you know, he's a cinematographer, he's a scientist. He's not a cinematographer.
Yeah, so
he's
absolutely amazing. So he actually brought in a lot of stability, a lot of thought, a lot of decision making,
yeah,
especially on how the light and the set worked together, the action, the prosthetics. So he's phenomenal. And from India point of view, a very unusual choice for an action film. Mm-hmm. But what he was able to create with Nikhil was and ask the right questions and innovate, yeah, in many ways.
Well, another unusual choice, Raghav Jadhav. Extremely unusual choice. We've known him as a dancer, as an entertainer, as a reality TV show host, as a reality TV contestant participant. We've seen him like goof off on TV for years and years. Why did you want Raghav to play Fari?
So, you know, we were testing for almost like around 120 people. Yeah, the audition. And I was not getting that guy.
Yeah.
Because Fani is a mix of, like, from my point of view, Fani was a charmer as well as a person who is the most evil person alive on this planet. And when I saw Raghav's tape, what he did was, there was a scene where he was flirting with a girl, and the very next moment he turns out and he takes off his gun and starts robbing the place. Huh. So that was the audition scene. And when he did that, and I saw his tape, it was actually like for one moment he was the most charming person, and the next moment his eyes turned like ice cold. And when I saw that, I said, Chris is the guy, he's the guy. And it was a self-tape. We were shooting somewhere and he had said that. And we said that, you know, we need to test him again. And he again came down to Mumbai and I tested him. And then we were sold out.
Let's get into Fani a little bit. The writing of strong antagonist is just so important with so many writers just, you know, so many times overlook the importance of writing strong antagonist to bring up the grandness that much harder. Fani, now he is a cricket fan, he references Dhoni and Kohli, and he probably, you know, listens to Bollywood music and like hangs out with his friends and drinks Desi Daru and just has fun. Writing him, what were the challenges of creating an antagonist so strong but so relatable and so sort of you pity him at one point as well?
He was the first person I actually thought of. So when I started writing the script, I started writing with him. Like, it was funny whose scene I wrote first. And I don't know why, but it just made sense that we need to make antagonist the bigger one. A person who has, because from where I come from, I have seen a lot of criminals at that time when I was growing up. And all these guys, they're very regular looking people. You know, you don't need not have a scar on your face to make a person look like a criminal.
Yeah.
So these guys, when I used to see them, they used to be most charming people, and suddenly would go into the dark alleys and rob people off their bikes.
Yeah.
And I had known quite a few of them. So it's just like I borrowed it from my life and I put it out on paper.
He's incredible, and you found some incredible actors to play the part also. Lakshya. This is his first feature. He's done things before, smaller things, not really come into the national consciousness as he's about to now next week or not. working with a brand new actor for a film that is, you know, so many people are working on it, and it's such an important film to so many people. Talk to me about trusting Lakshya to play your comrade.
I think, you know, I've always described Lakshya as a coconut. Yeah, hard from outside, soft from inside.
Yeah, but the bowl of the brown on the outside, white on the inside. That's what coconuts are, no? Here? Brown people are actually white. Oh, well, that's not what he's going to say. Yes, but he's hard on the outside, soft on the inside. Guys, be serious. Be serious for a second.
Yeah, so, and that's what even Amrit is.
Yes.
So I met Lush, I was supposed to meet 4 or 5 other people as an auction. And I met Lush for almost around an hour and a half, and I narrated him the story,
yeah.
I told him the story. And, you know, while I was telling him the story, he was like, he was inching, he was just getting off his seat. His interest levels were just rising. By the time I finished the story, the first thing what he asked me was, "When are we starting?" And so for an Amrit, I needed a person who was very well known, who was was madly and deeply in love with Tulika, but at the same time, when he goes through, when the story goes south, he becomes a killing machine. And Lush is like that. Lush will go all out for his friends and his loved ones. You don't mess with him. that's what Lush is. And when I met him and I finished my meeting, I came out and messaged her. And I told her, I found out that I don't need to meet anybody. And like, she was telling me, you should meet other people. And I said, no, I don't want to meet this year. I found him. I don't want to meet anybody else.
See, that's a nice idea.
Also, he worked incredibly hard.
Yes, for sure.
8-9 months of non-stop rehearsals, of action training, 5-6 hours per day,
yeah.
Breaks, no cheat days. There was a time when he was just like, he was also supposed to go home, not just work on the set. So he was so in and so worked so incredibly hard.
Yeah.
Gave it all.
Yeah, even in that scene when he takes off his t-shirt.
Yes, that's when I shared it.
So that scene, for that scene, he was not having water or he was not eating for almost like 3-4 days. And we were supposed to shoot that, and we could not shoot it because our prosthetic bodies were not ready. He has to have all those prosthetic
bodies. Right, yeah.
So our prosthetic bodies were not ready, so we had to keep pushing it. And for 3 days, that poor boy did not drink water. Because You just needed.
That's a little insane.
Yeah. That's commitment.
That is commitment. That's how you become a movie star. Puneet, yeah, I know, right? Puneet, I know that Karan Johar ke saath kaam karna bahut matlab indie space mein producers ke sapne hote hain ki hum kabhi oh yes, I'm so sorry. That we will make films with Karan Johar at one point. But when you do, when you, now I know that you now have a further relationship with Dharma and you're making more, you know, films and things with them. But when this first finalized, then the first film that you're going to co-produce with Karan Johar is going to be this one with like 40, 50 deaths. How did that relationship start from?
I think the relationship with Dharma, our studio back in India, which actually makes a lot of big Bollywood films and Shah Rukh Khan movies and romance, they funded the film. And it's Dharma production led by Karan Johar and Apoorva Mehta. Our relationship with them started during Lunchbox 11 years ago. I produced a small film called Lunchbox, which really broke out the sports. And the truth is, we did out of 10, we picked up awards and we sold the whole world minus India. And for India distribution, Karan and Dharma came on board. And when he saw the film, he said, "Can you fall in love with somebody you've never met?" And that built the global marketing campaign of the film, and he became our distributor in India. And Puneet Vaid is one of the highest box office independent film in India, and also many places around the world. It did extremely well. So our relationship actually started 11 years ago, also on a very unusual film. So I would say that Karan is an absolute cinephile. And when we, and there's been an ongoing conversation on what are we doing next, let's do something else. We are doing 5, 6, 7 films a year, and we don't expect one. Maybe 1.5 that goes on to the next year and then becomes a film. So we, you know, for 11 years of the conversation, on and off. So when I said that, you know, there is an extreme action film because I was absolutely in love with the story, and he said, if you want to do it, you're on. And he's like, yeah, we should hear it, we should give a narration. We should. This was also a very difficult film to read. So this is very narration heavy. It needed to take over, really take over the audience who's, who you're telling the story on how it is designed. There's a lot of detail in the design of the plan, and Nikhil had written it like that. So I think in halfway through the narration, and all of you saw the film, and you saw the halfway point, and the title
said,
Titles. So at the halfway point, he said, I'm doing the film. So that's how it happened.
Now, I know this story because I've been talking to both of you about this film, but do please tell Nikhil why the title stage comes where it does at the midpoint of the film.
Because from there, killing starts.
Killing started way before
that. He starts killing from that.
Amrit actually goes starts from that point.
He's defending.
But this is a really, like, it's an unorthodox decision to put the title slate in the middle of the film.
So the entire credit goes to Shiv,
the
editor. I was watching the first lineup, and I don't like to watch this, I don't like to sit before the first lineup is done, because I feel the editors are storytellers themselves.
Let them
do.
One editor
here? So, you know, because if I'm sitting and I've taken a shot and I've spent 4 hours or 5 hours, I will start fighting with him. But no, you need to put that because I have spent so much. So you need to put that. So I don't want to be there. So when I started watching the film, after 2 minutes or 3 minutes, I realized that I haven't seen the title coming in. And after 10 minutes, I forgot.
Yeah.
I thought that he has forgotten, so he is not.
We'll discuss it later.
We'll figure out where it's going. And he's constantly looking at me. Like, all the time. He doesn't know what's going on. And then at 45 minute mark, it just happened. And it's oh my god. This is not moving. Any other scene is moving. This is not moving.
That's producer brilliant. Yeah.
Nobody needed convincing.
Yeah, that was brilliant. She was exceptional. One more question I have for you, Nikhil, and I don't know whose decision this was. To give the specific background music Ashish Shridharti gets. In his scenes, is that flamenco appearing when he enters the scenes? What is that music?
Screamers.
spaghetti western. So we go from the killing straight up to spaghetti western, and it's specifically when Ashish Vidyarthi is on screen.
Yes.
He's incredible. Yes. My God.
Yes. So it's because of that.
Because he's just. So to enhance his presence,
also the fact that the moment he comes, so people were supposed to get down from the train at that point, and he comes on the train.
Yeah.
And from there, the story, like, it's the first time that, he was, so the story was supposed to be like this, that funny and everybody had to get off the train from there, and in 30 minutes, and they're supposed to go away. But the moment he comes on board, he wants revenge because his girlfriend's gotten killed. So the moment he enters the train, the story has moved like one gear up. That's the reason why I needed that kind of an investment. And he is that character who kind of starts dictating the story from there onwards till the title.
There's so many weird and incredible things happening in this film. And they just make sense. They come together and it just makes sense. Are we doing Q&As or this is just... Do you want to take some questions from the audience?
Please.
All right, great. So if you have any questions from Patna fans, Pune fans, editors, anybody, do we have a mic? Okay. So just maybe over there. That gentleman over there.
Hi, I am in awe of this film. I'm blown away.
Thank you.
Still bathing in the adrenaline of it all. I wanted to ask you about what the process was finding the stunt choreographers, the fighters, and how you worked with them and brought this out.
What happened was this is the first action film I've done. Like, I've not done actions before this. So I had to write all the action when I was writing the script. And when I finished writing the script, I started, we started talking to different action choreographers. And it became a challenge because in India what happens is most of the action choreographers, they shoot the film. Like, they will shoot that part and the director's going to be sitting on the side.
Yeah.
Now I couldn't do this because this is 70% of the film. You know, then I should go and take a holiday and then come back. So I said that I can't let you do this. I just want you to choreograph this. And I want to shoot this myself. And they said, like, what actions have you done? I said, I haven't done any action. So then they said, then why should we put our career in your hands? Well, yeah, that's a fair point. Necessity is the mother of invention. So what happened was when we started looking for different kind of action choreographers, and that search took us to Mr. Oh, who is in South Korea. And he
part of Snowpiercer.
And it was Snowpiercer, and Avengers, and War, and even the last one.
Yeah.
So you're sitting at home and you're getting the best person.
Yeah.
We actually spoke to a lot of action directors in Southeast Asia. We spoke to people in Indonesia. We were speaking to many action directors, and as in our Zoom calls, I think Mr. Oh had the most brilliant, innovative ideas. He was taking our conversation forward. His ideas were enhancing what we wanted to create, and we just thought that he's amazing. And we had him in India for, I think, 4.5 months.
So what we did was we did storyboarding and he did previews, that's where those 10 beds went off. We had 52 beds and then we reduced it to 42 beds.
Compromise.
Yeah. So yeah. So that was the entire process from there on.
When you say that you had everything written down, like did you have everything written down? The toilet cover first gets stabbed in the back,
Amrit gets up, comes left, his right hand goes here, catches somebody's knife and then brings it to his right and pokes it into somebody's eye. It was that detailed.
How long did it take you to write all of this down?
I took 1.5 years, right?
Yeah, that makes sense. If you had said 1 month, I would have walked off.
Yeah. 1.5 years.
Okay.
Okay.
And many a times what used to happen was, this was, I was writing it during the first wave of COVID, and I was holed up in a house in one room, and I would, because I've never done an action.
Right.
So I would actually do shadow boxing myself, like I would get up and start doing this the way, or is this the way? And once my wife came in and she saw, what are you doing? I said, I'm writing. She said,
but is this like some of your COVID frustration also? Oh, yeah. Some frustration within this film? It makes so much more sense.
But on serious notes, you know, this is the first wave of COVID, and there was so much of insecurity, so much of fear. We didn't know that this COVID was going to end. And we're holed up in the house, there's so much of claustrophobia. So, yeah, so it just,
yes,
you know, it just slipped from my mind and just got into the...
I see that manifestation. So cool, dude. So cool. All right, should we do one question now on this side? Just whoever's facing their hand. Right, okay, right, gentlemen. Yes, red t-shirt.
Hi, was there any choice, or was there any hint of putting a musical number into this volume?
Song? Song? No, not really. We have songs. We have like four songs, but not in the film. But it is part of the film, part of the promotions. Yes. There are songs. There is a romantic number, there is an action number. There are two action numbers.
Which are now out on YouTube? Yes, the songs are now out on YouTube?
And they're great songs.
All right. There's one question right there behind the woman.
Have either of you ever been stabbed?
Have you been stabbed? No.
I've seen stabbing.
We came from Patna to Pune journey.
Strangely, I saw it in Pune.
Shall we go with, I'm sorry, I'm
so sorry, I'm just trying to cover a larger area.
Go behind, like there's somebody who's... No, one behind. Yes, over there. That lady. I want lady questions, please.
So you said that it went from 52 deaths down to 40, and I'm really curious if there was a death that you lost that you really, really loved, and if there was, can you describe it in detail?
You didn't get it out? Remind him of everything. In detail, she said.
Yeah, so there is a death which is, there are actually two deaths. One was, just before that washroom sequence, there were two more people who he burnt alive. He had kept a Zippo lighter inverted.
Yeah.
And the Zippo fluid was flowing down. And what he did was, and kept the door open, so the two wounds like a game and this saw. So he pushed them inside and threw a burning
object
and shut the door. So it burst inside. Yeah. So that was those two deaths. And one death which we cut actually. So it is a washroom. Yeah, we shot and we cut it out. Was the one where he killed a person with the door, but he did not die like that. So he had to pull him out, take him to the window, and he kept punching him to the time his brain is popped out.
You are such a gentleman. I've spent enough time with you now to feel like he's so sweet, but then I hear you talk.
Very sensitive.
Very sensitive, soft-spoken man. And then I hear you talk. He's curious about inside the head. It's interesting, like now that I know that you wrote this in the lockdown, it makes sense that this is a whole lot of this comes from the lockdown frustration. And I think that's all the time we have tonight. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Can you have
anything to say, guys?
Just one thing. Please
write your reviews online or, and no spoilers. Please watch the film for tonight and spread the word.
Thank you.